Guy Fawkes.
Hi, I'm Courtney from Guy Fawkes, and I'm here today to challenge you to draw St. Paul's Cathedral. St. Paul's Cathedral sits on the top of Ludgate Hill in the city of London, and it's one of London's most famous and beautiful buildings. This St. Paul's Cathedral was designed by Sir Christopher Wren and was completed in 1710. And I say this St. Paul's Cathedral because the previous St. Paul's Cathedral was destroyed in the Great Fire of 1666. As you can see, it's a really impressive building and very complicated. And today, we are going to draw it. Will you accept my challenge?
I accept the challenge.
Fantastic. When you first look at St. Paul's Cathedral, you may think, that is complicated. But if you start looking closely, you'll start to see some simple shapes. Here, what do you see? A circle? Yes. An arch? You're right. A triangle? Great. Some squares? Did you just say quadrilateral? Wow, you're smart. Yes, loads of quadrilaterals, loads of four-sided shapes. What else? We've got a cross shape? You're right. Some squiggles. And, oh yeah, you're right. That does look like a mushroom shape. So, can you draw a circle, an arch, a triangle, a square and other quadrilaterals? Can you draw some squiggles, a cross shape, and that mushroom shape? You can? Well then, you can draw St. Paul's Cathedral. St. Paul's Cathedral is tall, so I've got my paper set up in a portrait position. And St. Paul's Cathedral also really likes to get bigger than the paper. So I recommend having some extra paper and some tape just in case your drawing decides to get bigger than the paper you've got. The biggest question when starting any drawing is, where do I start? And with St. Paul's, I'm going to start about here. I want to leave a little bit of space at the top for the very top of the dome, but I'll start here with a nice rectangle. And then I'm going to come down with a big dome from there, so two giant curvy lines. The dome is the most famous part of St. Paul's Cathedral. At the bottom of the dome is a flat rectangle. I'm going to leave the dome for now and I'm going to move down to about here where we have a statue of St. Paul. And he is on a pedestal. And I'm going to draw another rectangle for that. Not as big as the first one, but enough space to put St. Paul on here. And St. Paul carries a sword. And you'll see that sword on the City of London flag. It's a red sword. And then coming down on both sides of this statue is a giant triangle. And once you've got that triangle in place, you can start putting the other statues' pedestals. A triangle on either side, and then a rectangle on top of that. And then on this side, we've got St. Peter. And this is St. James. Now, with your drawing, it's your drawing. So you can draw the statues however you want to draw them. I've seen statues of aliens, teddy bears, all sorts of things. So have fun with the statues because it's your drawing. Okay, so we've got our dome. We've got our pediment, which is this triangle shape. And now I'm just going to build out the base of the dome. We'll start right here, next to St. Paul, with a rectangle coming out either side. There's a rectangle on the left side, and a rectangle on the right side. And then on top of those are circles. And then we join that up with a line that goes behind our statue of St. Paul. Okay, so for now we're gonna leave that behind and we're gonna continue down here. There's a big rectangle here called an architrave. And this is where we get to do our lovely mushroom shapes. And the key thing about St. Paul's is that the columns that we draw are always an even number. So if you have space for 8 columns, that's great. If you have space for 6 columns, that's great. 4, that's great. 7, wah, wah, no. So in order to make the even numbers, I'm gonna use my thumb and I'm gonna go straight down from St. Paul here, and then I'm gonna draw a mushroom shape on either side. And then I'm gonna take a look at this because it looks like I might have space for 2 more mushrooms on this side and 2 more on that side. So I'm gonna end up with 6 mushrooms. And I'll put those in now. And it's okay if your mushrooms get a little scrunched or a bit squished up, because that's part of the charm of drawing this by hand. So I've got my 6 mushrooms. Now I'm going to come down with the shafts of the columns. And the shafts are basically long, skinny rectangles. And then at the bottom of each of those rectangles is the base of the column. So we've got the first set of columns in, which is great. We then have another set of columns, and this is much wider. So this is a pretty important moment for your drawing. You want to make a large rectangle that comes out wide enough that it would fit 2 more of your columns.
What? What?
Can you say that again?
You want to make a large rectangle that comes out wide enough that it would fit 2 more of your columns. Okay, wish me luck. That seems wide enough. I'll keep my fingers crossed on that. Next, another set of columns. And we're getting pretty low on our paper here. So I want these columns, the new columns, to line up right under the ones on top. So I'll draw my mushrooms. And then keep drawing them out from there. And then, like we said, we want two more columns here. Okay, and then we need those shafts, which, again, are rectangles. I think Sir Christopher Wren must have gone to the rectangle shop and bought all the rectangles they had. And you can see with my columns, they're a little bit wonky and they're a little bit different size and shape, but that's all part of the charm of drawing something like this. And at the bottom of each shaft is a base. That's right. Excellent. And then we can start on the steps. And the steps are rectangles. Now, I think I probably have space for about 6 steps. If you have less space, you can draw fewer steps. If you have more space and you want to, you can draw more steps. I will leave that to you. Take a little moment and give yourself a pat on the back if you've come this far. You've done a lot of work. Now we can start going up both sides. And the great thing is, St. Paul's Cathedral is symmetrical. So anything we draw on this side, we also need to draw on that side. And I'm going to start with a pretty big rectangle, a flat rectangle. On either side of the steps, there's a big rectangle here. And same on this side. You may see my head go back and forth a little bit as I'm checking my drawing. I want to make sure that the different parts line up as I'm building back up these towers. And now that I've drawn these rectangles at the bottom here, these mark the width of my building. So you'll also see me looking up and down to make sure that lines up. I'm going to look at these levels. So this level here and the level up here of the architrave. And I want to draw a simple rectangle coming out straight out of the left side of this and extending all the way above the bottom here. And then the same on this side. And then on this level, I want to draw a rectangle that's close, but doesn't quite touch. Nice, long, flat rectangle. And then the same on this side. Fantastic. And then I'm going to put a tiny rectangle on top of that. And then the same on this side. And then I'm going to put our next four statues. Rectangle, 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 rectangle. And these are the statues of the four authors of the Gospels: Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. Okay, coming straight out of our lovely gospel writers are lines that go straight up. There's a fantastic shape on this tower here, and it kind of looks like a rectangle swallowed half of a donut. So it's a rectangle with an arch in the middle of it. I'm going to start in the middle of my tower, and I'm going to draw that arch first, and then I'm going to draw a rectangle coming out of either side. And then do the same on this side. An arch in the middle, and then that rectangle coming out of either side. And in these towers are a circle, and there's a circle inside the circle. So a giant circle with a circle inside it. St. Paul's has a clock, and the big bell at St. Paul's is called Great Tom. So if you're ever passing by St. Paul's and it strikes the hour, you can say to your friend, "There's Great Tom striking the hour." Let's keep going up. We've got some more rectangles to build these towers out. So we'll just go through here quite slowly. Rectangle. Rectangle, 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 a little rectangle on top of these. And then I'm going to join those together. And then we've got four columns. And with these columns, I'm going to challenge you to draw them from the bottom. So we'll start with the bases, which are rectangles. I'm going to draw two in the middle of each tower. And then more rectangles for the bases here. And then we've got the shafts going up from there, which again, rectangles. Just trying to make sure that they're the same height on my paper. And then at the top, we've got those mushrooms, which are the capitals on the top of the columns. So more mushrooms, making me hungry. And if I'm going too fast, you know what to do. Press pause or rewind. Watch the part of the video again that you need to, and then catch back up. Columns, we've got four rectangles just right on top of each other. From there, we're going to go up with some nice big squares on both sides. And then on top of those squares, we'll have a long, skinny rectangle. We're building some little domes here. And then at the very top, you can either draw a tiny rectangle with a circle on the top, or you can draw a little chess piece. So each of these needs a little cross on the top of it. Then on either side of the rectangles on your tower, there are big crosses, and I'm going to challenge you to draw nice, big, chunky crosses. On this tower, two crosses, and on this tower, two crosses. Then in the middle of our rectangle are three arches, and when you have an odd number of things, you can draw the one in the middle first, and then draw the other arches on either side. I'm going to come to this level, and I'm going to draw some columns. I'm going to start on the outside here, and I'm going to draw my mushrooms. And then these columns, there are two that we want to have touch this long rectangle that we drew some time ago. And then we can draw the shafts coming down. And don't forget to leave space for the base. Same on this side. And then the bases. So you've got your columns in. Now we're going to come down to this level, and guess what? More columns. These columns have a special rectangle at the top. And then the mushroom capitals. And then the shaft. And in this case, I'm going to draw one base for two columns. That's a big rectangle. Now we've got some details we get to put in. On this level that we've just drawn our columns, I'm going to draw a little cloud shape with a circle underneath it. Same on this side. And then underneath is an arch. And underneath that arch shape is a little square. And these are just some of the details of St. Paul's that make it really a great drawing. Up here on the next level, we've got this little house shape called an edicule. And the house shape has an upside down V shape at the top, and then it comes down into a rectangle. And then underneath that is a small rectangle. And finally, to finish our edicule, we're going to put some lines coming down. And then just above the edicule, if you have space, there are some little triangles. Okay, so it's starting to take shape. We need some doors so that people can visit. The great door here, it's so big that it goes behind the columns. And then on the left side here, I'm just gonna draw another line. That's the door for visitors. And just because it's symmetrical, I'm gonna put another door here. On the level up from that, we've got windows. And I'm gonna start in the middle, and I'm gonna draw a big window, and then some smaller windows. And I'm going to challenge myself to draw a window behind these columns. And then we're going to start joining these up. So a line between these two. Same on this side. And then underneath is an arch. Same on this side. And then a triangle inside this triangle. And in this is a frieze. It's not a frieze because it's cold. It's a frieze because it's a flat sculpture. And it's a frieze of a scene from St. Paul's life. But I'm just gonna draw a squiggle, something like that. And then we're going to come up and finish out our dome. Just some lines. Same on this side. I'm gonna go all the way up to the top now because I can't forget to do my amazing big cross at the top. I'm gonna come with a rectangle. And then another rectangle on top of that. And on the very top up here is a huge cross. And on either side here, I'm just gonna draw a line with a circle on the top. Now the dome, we want it to look like it's 3D and coming toward us, so I'm gonna draw some other curvy lines. And then a line down the middle. Then I've got these clear story windows. I'm gonna draw the clear story windows just as rectangles. You're gonna love these tiny little squares. And if you're like me, you think those look a little bit like teeth. And in fact, they are called dentils, which sounds a lot like dentist and dental. So they are teeth. just going to look at my picture and see if there's anything that I might have missed as I was drawing. I'm going to check this side and make sure that side is symmetrical. It looks like we are done. So I want you to give yourself a great big pat on the back. And then I have one more challenge for you. And that is, now that you've drawn St. Paul's Cathedral, pick another building and try to draw that. Maybe it's the place you live or the place you go to school or some other building that you like in your hometown. But take a look at it, see if you can start seeing simple shapes, and then give it a try. Thanks for joining me today to draw St. Paul's Cathedral, and I hope you will join me again soon for another Guy Fawkes drawing challenge.